Good evening, everybody. I think we have everybody here who is planned to arrive. Thank you so much for coming. This is the 2021 Winter Sports Awards. We're still using all of our safety procedures, so thank you for sitting in your socially distanced, safe, assigned seats for tonight. The program will be pretty normal to what we have done in the past. Mr. McCracken is up in the video booth, who's helping me with the slideshow. We are also recording this so that your teammates who can't be here tonight can then view the award ceremony tomorrow. Coaches, Mr. McCracken's also asked me to remind all of us that when you're speaking and giving your award to speak into the microphone, because sometimes it cuts in and out. So just try to do that, and then it'll be great sound for the video. So if we can go to the next slide, Chris. So this is our agenda for the evening. We will just be handing out the team special awards tonight. Before we get to that point, I did want to recognize a few people with some thank yous that have allowed this season to happen. When are you ready, Chris? There we go. There's been a number of people that have helped make this season possible, and without everybody on this screen, I don't know if we could have done it. It's been a challenge, but it's been a creative opportunity to collaborate and to communicate and to problem solve and to, who would have ever thought it, actually complete a winter sports season for each one of our teams. I'm real proud of what everybody put into this season. It's been a lot of hard work by everybody. And if you look at this list, you can see that it's obviously more than just myself. It takes a lot of planning to make sure that everything's set up, all the procedures are followed, that the games actually happen. And just if you look at this list, there are so many people who I want to thank. I'm not going to read down through them all, but you can see for yourself. Some are behind the scenes, some are the people that you see at the games. But thank you so much to all of you, especially the last bullet up there. The coaches, as always, couldn't do it without you guys. The parents who are here tonight, thank you for your support and your understanding and your flexibility, and just knowing that this was not a normal season, and you guys doing whatever we asked you to do so that we could have this season. I said that at the beginning of the season, not what we have to do, what we get to do. And I just want to thank you so much for that, because you were always right there, even though you didn't get the answer sometimes that you might have wanted. You understood that we were doing this so that our kids could have their season. And of course, the athletes, there aren't that many of you here tonight, but congratulations for playing your part. And we've had such a special season. If you look at the next slide, so many things for us to be proud of, not only just finishing our season that the kids had cut short last year, and that we didn't have it all in the spring. But you know, the girls alpine skiing are once again the Division II champions. Boys alpine, you know, second place. Ski jumping, state, and some would say national champions. The Nordic skiing for the girls, second place. Boys Nordic, fourth place. After both jumping up to Division I this year, boys basketball having a successful season and making the D2 playoffs. Ice hockey making it to the semifinals, and girls basketball, as we all know last night, being runners-up in Division II this year. This isn't taking away from any of the individual accomplishments as well. There's a number of different individual accomplishments in all of these different sports that we have to be proud of, but these are just the team championships or other playoff things that we were able to do this year. So without any further ado, I do wanna just start the program. It's gonna be a pretty brief evening tonight, but just to go over some of the protocols. So I'll call the coaches up. They'll talk about their awards. The awards will be handed to the athlete, and then the coach and the athlete will go stand in front of the backdrop and have their picture taken. Masks do need to stay on, of course, and then you can go back to your seat. At the end, we'd like to have a group shot of all the special award winners before you leave, and then I can give you your box before you walk out too, if you want to slide it back into the protective holder in the box, so it's safe on your trip home. Okay, so up first is Coach Jack Loyne for the boys basketball program.
Okay, first of all, congratulations to all the teams. Like Neil said, I think it was an accomplishment just to have a full season, to play 15 basketball games. I would not have put the probability of that too high, for those of you that remember their probability and statistics. But we did, and I think to have the opportunity to compete and to play basketball, especially the way that last season ended, just the opportunity to finish the season was great. So congratulations to all the teams, and I do appreciate all the people that helped to make this happen. Boys basketball has two awards. The first is the Carl Seidenstecker Award. And unfortunately, the student that's receiving this award, the player that's receiving this award, is not able to be here tonight. But it's a player who has most dedicated to the team, voted by his teammates as the most dedicated to the team, and also to the sport of basketball. Pretty common to have a rigorous Sunday morning practice for an hour and a half, and he would ask me if he could go to my gym and shoot right after that. And I was exhausted from coaching. I couldn't imagine how he would have enough energy to do that. But has worked incredibly hard in the off season from May until the season started, just hoping that he'd get to play. Nick Houghton-McClair. And the second one is the Sutt Marshall Award. And this goes to a player with outstanding commitment to the team, sportsmanship, character. I have coached this player since he was in the fifth grade, actually, in the MWV Eagles AAU. Kept working, kept improving, and this year showed outstanding leadership, is a great leader in the school as well, Matt Nordwick.
Congratulations, Matt and Nick. The next award is the Girls Basketball Award, and Coach Larry Meter will present that this evening.
Good evening, everyone. I too just want to just say that so happy we were able to have a season this year. You know, the thank yous, you know, school board, school, Kevin Carpenter, Kevin Richard, absolutely, but I think a big thank you needs to go to these two guys here, who kind of put everything together. They've been doing it for the fall, they've been doing it for the winter, and without these two, nothing would have happened, so thanks. Okay, it's been a long weekend. I'll try to get through this. The Girls Basketball Award is given to a, in honor of longtime basketball coach and educator, Bob Russell. The award is given annually to a player who demonstrates pride, determination, leadership, behavior, enthusiasm in the sport of basketball. There could not be a more perfect recipient than this year's winner. As a freshman, she made an immediate impact on the team, a team that she would lead to the state championship game twice in 4 years. If she hadn't suffered a major knee injury her junior year, that may have been three. Her commitment to her rehab, her determination to come back stronger than before, brought her back ready for a standout senior season. This year's recipient was named to the Division II All-State team as a sophomore. Yesterday, she was named to this year's Division II All-State first team. In addition, she was named a member of this year's Division II All-State All-Defensive team. She's a 4-year varsity player, 3-year starter, a captain, a special player, and a very special young lady. Congratulations, Maddie Stewart.
So I just also got an email I always get emails and texts, and people make fun of me when I say email and it was a text. But this is an email, and it says, hi Neil, I was thinking about featuring Maddie Stewart in our Hometown Hero segment. Your thoughts? If you like the idea, I think I like the idea. Can you help me get in touch with her? So, I'm getting in touch with you, so that you, and I will get him in touch with you. He needs to set up a Zoom interview. But congratulations, you're going to be a hometown hero, WNU. The next thing that I need to look at my phone for is also an email. This is from Miss Benjamin, and it's the Unified Basketball Award winner, who unfortunately can't be here with us tonight, so she just asked me to do the quick presentation. She said, Emily Benjamin is the Unified Basketball coach. And she said, this year's recipient of the Unified Basketball Award is Jasmine Morrison for her hard work during practices and great sportsmanship during games. So congratulations, Jasmine, you're out there. We will get you your award. Congratulations. Up next, after that, is ice hockey. And Coach Lane is here to present the Jim Terry Award.
So, congratulations to all the winter sports athletes, and I also would like to echo what the other previous coaches have talked about. There was a 2-week period over Christmas break where I'm pretty sure I talked to Colby and Neil more than I talked to my own family. I had them on speed dial, and they were extremely supportive all season, and like Larry said, we couldn't have done this season without them, so thank you guys very much for everything you guys did. The Jim Terry Award is given annually at the conclusion of each season to the player who has demonstrated excellence in determination, discipline, leadership, and sportsmanship both on and off the ice. This year's recipient is no surprise. He will graduate this season holding the Kennett goaltending record for minutes played in his career, shots faced, and saves. He has been part of a quarterfinalist, a semifinalist, a runner-up team, and a state championship team. His leadership on the ice and off the ice helped us navigate this extremely difficult senior season for him. This year, due to player numbers, we played 3 defensemen. This is virtually unheard of. We were able to do this, however, and do it successfully due to his incredible ability not only to stop the puck, but to play the puck out of his net. With him in net, it was like having an extra defenseman. Last Wednesday night, he had one of his best goaltending performances of his career, making 40 stops in a semifinal 1-0 loss in overtime to Hollis Brookline Dairy Field. What probably most people don't know is the game winner actually went off one of our defensemen's shin pads. It was clear they weren't going to score on him clean, and that's the only way they could win the game. Recently agreed to continue his hockey career playing for the Maine Moose. I know he's going to have a ton of success beyond Kennett High School. I, as a head coach, will miss him greatly next year and for years to come. He has redefined what a Kennett hockey player should be, both on and off the ice, and in doing so has left his mark, and in my humble opinion, he is the best goaltender that Kennett has had in his program history. Tonight, he becomes just the second goalie in the program's 22-year history to receive this award. Congratulations to the 2021 Jim Terry Award winner, Senior Captain Bryson Robleski.
Coach Livingston is up and ready. He's coming down to present the Indoor Track Awards, and this is another example of just, there's so many things that come to my mind about this season, but you know, the Indoor Track found out early on that they weren't going to have a season. The facilities didn't, you know, want to host all the teams, but you know, Coach Livingston, being the man that he is, said, I still want to have practices with these athletes if they still want to come. And so they continued to just go ahead and practice, even though they really knew that they had no meet or state championship to look forward to. So without further ado, Coach Livingston and the Indoor Track Awards.
Thank you. The Indoor Track Award is presented to the member of each team who, both on the field and in the school, best demonstrates the qualities of loyalty to Kennett High School, citizenship, and sportsmanship, both as a follower and as a leader. This year, I'm very pleased and proud to present the Girls Team Award to Olivia Curry. Equally pleased and proud to present the Boys Team Award to Bryce Hill.
Up next, Coach Zengelowski is going to present the Damon Emile Award and the EKB3, the coolest named award, I think, that we have, Spirit of Scheme.
Good evening, everyone. In terms of the 2020-2021 ski season, I think there were a lot of concerns early on in terms of what was going to happen. But I think out of all the teams, we were lucky enough to have the most normal season. There was no base lodge, there were no amenities like that, but I think in general, our ski team had one of the most successful seasons that we could have ever had. And a lot of that came down to the four individuals that we're gonna be recognizing tonight. Not only are those four athletes four-year members of the Kennett ski team, but they represent everything that's so phenomenal about our program. They represent the leadership, pride, commitment to our program, and drive that it takes to be a state champion here at Kennett High School and in the state of New Hampshire. In terms of the Kennett ski team, when it comes to all of the teams, Alpine teams across the state, we are the team to beat. And for 4 years, these kids have committed to this program, to our school, to our community, and have represented everything that is amazing about skiing for Kennett High School and our greater community. I have two awards to give out tonight, the first of which is in honor of Ed Bradley, our longtime coach for the Kennett ski team. And the Ed Bradley Award has been given out for the last few years now to recognize the athletes that are ultimately the heart of the team. Their commitment, their effort, their image, their leadership, their loyalty, everything that they provide to the Kennett ski team is what makes us who we are and makes us the successful team that we are statewide. And without further ado, I want to recognize for the EKB Spirit of Kennett Award, Grace Ward and Bobby Graustein.
Thank you.
last two awards that I have to give out is the Damon O'Neill Award. The Damon O'Neill Award has been given out by the Kennett Ski Team for decades in honor of Damon O'Neill, a young alpine racer who grew up skiing in the ESSC program locally and even nationally before tragically passing away in a ski accident. The family asked Kennett High School to give an award in his honor for the athlete that represents team camaraderie, leadership, and most importantly, ability. These last two awards go to two of the strongest members of the Kennett Ski Team that I've seen in quite some time. Without their commitment to the sport, their passion for the sport, and their overall presence on the team, we wouldn't have been the successful team that we were over the past 4 years. These two are leaving very big shoes to fill. This award goes to none other than Skylar Sayers and Mackenzie Carr.
Ultimate award for the evening, love saying that word, goes to the ski jumping team. Coach Henry is here to present the Flying Eagles Award.
We had a great season. The kids did a fantastic job. We didn't really let the COVID drag us down at all. And, we had a little bit of a late start. Snow, the Christmas time, we had all that rain that kind of took our snow away, but as soon as it came back, our athletes were out there every night practicing, and our season started off, our first few meets with Hanover taking the team title, but after competing in each meet, we got a little bit closer and a little bit closer, and by the end of the season, we brought home a plaque, so that was pretty cool to watch. This year's recipient of the Ski Jumping Award, it's been an honor coaching her for the last 4 years. Usually when you start ski jumping, you're a little apprehensive and a little nervous, but after 4 years, I don't think she's scared of anything. Her confidence level at the state meet was just unreal, and she took the best jumps of her entire high school career, when it counted, and she's our NHIA state champion, ladies state champion also, Elizabeth Krosky.
Ski Team Award, and I see Coach LaJoy and Donahoe up there, so I guess it's Coach LaJoy is looking like he's coming down. Coach Fosberg isn't here this evening, so they're stepping in for the Nordic Ski Award.
Yeah, we also had a really great season this year. The Nordic team has put together a lot of great seasons in a row, and this year was no different. The girls coming in second, the boys coming in fourth. We have Carly Krebs earn State Ski Meister Award, which is the top combination, both Nordic and Alpine, and so she took those top honors. We had three boys and five girls qualify for the Eastern State Championship. Championship, which is basically the top 25 kids in the state for their age bracket. So that was another, you know, outstanding, and they raced this past weekend, and we had some pretty good success there as well. So tonight's major award winner, goes to a female who has been just an incredible integral member of this team since she started. She's definitely our MVP senior here. In her 4 years, she skied for several state championships. She got the runner-up this year. She made Easterns. She's been our go-to leader for sure this year. Whenever we needed somebody to lead warm-up or to lead a ski, if we needed an idea for a fun Friday, she would be the person that we would go to. She is an absolute joy to coach, and gonna definitely miss her and her presence on the team in the years to come. And that would be Shannon Derby.
Shannon. In closing, I just wanted to thank everybody for such a great season. It's one I'll never forget, just like in the fall, very memorable. I really like this quote. I've used it before, but I think it really sums up what each of you have accomplished, not only this year, but maybe in your four-year high school career. You're not here by accident. You know, these things are the things that you've put in to get to the place where you're at tonight. You should be very proud of everything that you've accomplished. And speaking of being proud, I just think back to a year ago. We've heard a lot about how this week or this past weekend or whatever is kind of the one-year anniversary, where I can still remember on a Sunday being called down to our SAU office, and we started planning out how we were going to go to remote instruction. And we did that for the rest of the season, and as the athletics director, people kept asking me, they're like, well, what are you doing? There's no sports going on. And I'm like, well, come sit in my office one day and I'll show you what's keeping me busy. And one of the things that we were trying to figure out at that time was, well, how do we get something for the winter sports season from last year? And so we decided to mail out the awards, ask everybody to send me back a picture, produce a video. That's what we were able to do last year. This is what we're able to do this year. So I'm so happy to see us continuing to take these steps in the right direction. Back to normalcy, whether it's with athletics, whether it's with education, or whether it's just being able to go to the supermarket or whatever. So we're making good steps. We're proving that we can do this safely. I'm looking forward to a spring season. If any of you guys are planning on playing a spring sport, we'll see you out there. But otherwise, thank you all again. Have a great night. Stay safe, and we'll see each other soon. Thank you. So if we could just get a picture with all of the special award winners in your awards, and then afterwards come on over and I'll give you your box so you can take that home with you if you want to put it in there to keep it safe.